Hey there, Mark Yegge here. I'm a wealth architect and I help 7- and 8-figure investors play offense and defense with their investments. And today we're going to be talking about the market crash that's slowly developing before our eyes and what you can do about it. All right, so we've got some severe selling going on right now. It's the beginning of December now, right at the end of November, and we've got some severe selling in the markets. Now, we all kind of knew this was happening, and everybody's been predicting a market crash for 4 years, right? Let's be serious. And a stopped clock is right twice a day. So you can say that you saw it coming, but you have to be invested or not invested to be able to see it coming. If you're staying in cash most of the time, you're not able to make any money in these markets that have been melting up. And now that there's a bit of a meltdown going down, you can look back and go, oh, thank God I was in cash. But you would have missed out on all this opportunity for the last several months or years. So you have to be invested at the right times. But you know what? A lot of people say that timing the market doesn't work. And I totally disagree. And you have to be out of the markets when things are going down and in the markets when things are going up. You go, oh, well, Mark, you can't predict when things are going up. Well, maybe you can, but you can certainly get probabilities on your side. And 4 days ago, I came out and to my subscribers, I told them that the market was turning red. And I said, respect the red. Respect the red basically means you're either in cash or you're hedged really deep in the money. And you're protected against these downsides. Now, I've had an incredibly great week this week while the markets have been tumbling because I was prepared for them. And that's what market timing can do for you. And if you're a buy and hope investor or buy and hold, right, you just put money in, you go, oh, it'll come back one of these days. Well, sometimes it does. And sometimes it doesn't, right? Certain stocks come back. The market always comes back over time. Or do you think it does? And actually the dollar is going down, making you think that the market is going up. But at the end of the day, certain stocks will continue to go up. You know, we all believe that Apple will continue to be in business. We all think that Google is going to be around. Facebook's going to be around, whatever. But there are certain stocks that go down and never come back up, right? Or they stay down for 10 years or 20 years like Cisco did. And so you've got to just be ready. And why would you want dead money sitting out there if you can avoid it? So you have to learn to time the market. So let's talk about what's going on in the market now. We just had a 600 point down day in the Dow. We had an up day yesterday, which was basically a fake dead cat bounce where they manipulated it up, made you think everything was going up, and then they slammed it down again today. And they're blaming the Omicron variant or whatever they're blaming, the excuse du jour, which, you know, you can decide if you get to believe it or not, but selling is selling. And then before that, it was a 900 point Dow drop on Friday. So you've got to be really diligent with your money. You've got to be careful. So being out of the markets when things are going down is something that you got to do. And you don't want to do it when it's too late, because then you get out at the wrong time and then you're behind the curve trying to get back in. Let's take a look at what these markets are looking like right now. So here you see the New York Stock Exchange, and these are the daily indicators here. You can see that this market's, you know, been trending up for a while, but since it's so zoomed out, it's really hard to see the granularity of what's going on over here on the right. But if you start to look down, you look at the oversold oscillator, right? Right now we're showing that it's oversold. And as the market's been kind of melting up, it's been, you know, pretty good. It hasn't been in the overbought condition very much, but now it's getting into that oversold territory. And you can look here at the 10-day moving average, right? And this is the moving average of the volume up and the volume down. Volume up is in blue and the volume down is in red. And you're seeing there's a huge amount of crossover after the crossover of volume red going up, right? So there's a lot of selling. The sellers are in control right now. And if you're trying to paddle upstream, swimming against these sellers, you're doing the wrong thing. It's better to just get out of the way and let them sell and then go back and when they've calmed down, which I don't know when will be. Nobody can figure that out. But I can tell you in the last 3 days of trading, it's wiped out about a month and a half of gains. The market takes the stairs up and then it takes the elevator down. And it just slams that money that you've made over the last year and a half, or sorry, month and a half or 2 months. It slams it away in just a day or two. And that's what can happen in these markets. So it's better to respect the red, like I tell my subscribers, and know that the markets are going red. I use a series of indicators that, you know, that it's not perfect, but we're right about 75-80% of the time. And we don't know exactly when they're going to stop and when they're going to start. And we just know that the trends are reversing. And when those trends are reversing, we respect them. Let's look at the bottom one here. This is the 10-day moving average of new highs versus new lows. And you're seeing there's no new highs really being made right now. It's coming down significantly, and the new lows are going up significantly. You see there's a crossover. We haven't seen a crossover in a long time, since a year ago when we had some selling. And so you've got to watch that. You've got to respect that. You can take a look at the regular market. Here's the S&P 500, and I want to draw your attention to these three bars on the right. Now, we had significant selling on that Thanksgiving Friday. It was only a half a day, so you don't see it as significant. It was only 18% less than normal average volume, but the market was only open a half a day. So if you look at that, it's more than average volume. And then today, we had gigantic volume. It's 106% of its normal volume. It's double, basically. So there's some selling going on. It's heading right for this 50-day moving average, and it could be heading for this 200-day moving average. You've got to be careful because these markets can really swing back and forth, and you don't want to try to be solvent in these markets while they're going down. So respect the market. I'm going to give you one more graph. I'm going to show you this 15-minute graph on the S&P 500. Look at that. Now, it looks all normal when the market was going up, and you know this is in a fairly tight range. We had a gap up, and we had a peak high, and we tried to make another high, and that was kind of a warning sign. We couldn't make a new high, and then we had some serious volume selling coming in there, right? See that about a week ago? And then it kind of stayed within a range right in here, right, which is fine. And then this huge gap down right there, huge gap down. That's gigantic, right? And it did it on good volume, significant volume. And it came down, it ended at its low. We had a gap up during the dead cat bounce of a couple of days ago. And then boom, another gap there. And then look at this selling that happened here over today. It was just a lot of selling. Everything was hunky-dory in the morning. And then bam, down. Bam, and it even closed near the lows of the day. So that doesn't portend much positivity coming in the future, but you got to be careful in these markets. That's all I'm trying to tell you. You can time the market. You just got to be careful when the markets are moving against you, because it takes a while to make that money back up, especially if the market doesn't recover quickly. Good luck. By the way, if you want to learn more, if you want to join some of my ecosystems, we have books and courses and masterminds and mentorships and all kinds of really cool things to get the probabilities in your favor. You know, I help wealthy investors play offense and defense by creating safe, reliable income. But it all comes from a system, guys. It all comes from a system. And if you want to learn to do anything right, you've got to have a system. It can't just be, I watched a YouTube video and now I'm going to go throw my good hard-earned money. You need to learn a system. And I've been doing this for 44 years, and I think I've got some really cool programs for you to learn. Anything worth doing is worth doing right. You might as well learn it right. You might as well put the time and effort into something that's going to make you money for the rest of your life. Go to one of my sites. The main one is called hackingmoney.com. You can click there. You can go to the products tab. You can see what we have to offer for you so you can take your trading to the next level. And maybe I'll even see you at one of my events. In any case, I hope you join one of my ecosystems, and I hope we see each other down the road.